Good evening and welcome back to our virtual Dominion Energy Jazz Café. It's always my pleasure to welcome you to our latest installment. Tonight, behind you and next to me, we're welcoming the Charles Owens Trio, courtesy of the Richmond Jazz Society, to the program. Charles et al., we'll talk later. For now, the stage is yours.
Thank you. Thanks, everybody. Welcome to the virtual performance at here at VMFA for the Richmond Jazz Society. We are the Charles Owens Trio. On the drums, we have the great Richmond legend, DeVonne Harris, DJ Harrison, on the drums.
Hey.
On the, usually the bass, but something new that he's trying out that he's sounding amazing on, it's a hybrid guitar. On the hybrid guitar, we have Andrew Randazzo. That's my name. We started out just now with, excuse me, a song called In a Sentimental Mood by Duke Ellington. And we're gonna continue now with a song by Thundercat. This one's called Heartbreaks and Setbacks. Thank you. Thundercat is one of my favorite musicians, also one of our favorite musicians. I hope he gets to see that at some point. We love his music. All right, thank you, Steve Bruner.
That's his birth name.
All right, so we're gonna play another song now by another great composer that we're all fans of as well. A little bit different era, but this is called She's Always a Woman by Billy Joel. Thank you. Yes, Billy Joel, she's always a woman.
Do you know what time we started? I think we did like it's okay, just I should have taken note of that. I think we started at like 6:20.
All right, thank you so much for having us, VMFA and Richmond Jazz Society. We really appreciate the opportunity to come do this video for you and play together. The next song I'm going to do is a song by Marvin Gaye. This is called What's Going On. And we're going to use the arrangement that was come up with by Donny Hathaway. So arranged by Donny Hathaway, What's Going On. Thank you.
Charles Owens and the Charles Owens Trio. War is not the answer. No. What's going on indeed, gentlemen? I find myself, so far tonight, a little bit caught up, a little bit lost in the bramble of sound coming from the stage, and I don't want to be found. This has been a joy.
Same with us, man.
I can tell, I can feel it. Yep. I can hear it, and I'm looking forward to set two, but first, it's time for a break. Would you have a chat with me?
Absolutely.
Well, let's take a break.
Let's go.
Charles Owens Trio. Mr. Owens, welcome to the program and welcome to the interview section. I really enjoyed this first half. Thank you so much for that.
Me too. You're welcome. It's what I do.
It shows. Before we get into our discussion, would you take a few moments to just let the audience, those who don't know you, can you tell them a little bit about yourself in your own words?
Oh, sure. I was born in Virginia, and I went to some really good arts magnet high schools, one in Washington, D.C., Duke Ellington School for the Arts, School of the Arts, and then I graduated from a high school in Miami called New World School of the Arts, which is also an arts magnet high school, and I got amazing musical education and great teachers there, non-musical and musical, on both of those schools. I was born in Virginia. After I graduated in 92 from Miami, I went to the New School for Social Research, and I studied jazz improvisation and performance and composition at the New School for Social Research with some great masters. And I've been a recording artist, saxophonist, performer, pianist since I've 16 is when I think I started gigging.
Wow.
That's when I first had my first gig. I think I was 15 or 16. It was at a pool hall, I remember.
Wow.
And I've just always loved music. I've been obsessed since I can remember. I decided that I was going to be a professional musician, when I was 11. And when I was 11, I was already really seriously into music and classical music. And then I saw the movie Amadeus, about Mozart's life and death. And right there, I remember the moment very vividly still when I was 11 years old that I decided that I was going to be a musician for the rest of my life. And then when I was in high school, I decided that I wanted to be the best saxophone player in the world.
Wow. Let's settle a little bit on these early years for a moment, if you don't mind.
Mm-hmm.
So 11 years old. We've just learned you decide then you're going to be a musician.
Yeah.
You had to have encountered music before 11. Can you recall what first got you interested in sounds and putting them together?
Well, there's some pretty famous pictures of me, or famous in our family, I should say, of pictures of me when I was 1.5, 2 years old, in diapers, holding myself up at the piano, barely able to just balance but still play. I've always been really fascinated with chords and the piano, and I've always had a really good ear for music. One of the ways I taught myself music when I was a kid was just listening to songs on the radio and on television and try to pick them out. Just by ear.
Can you recall some of those songs?
Sure. One of them was Jump by Van Halen.
Okay.
You know that famous keyboard part that goes boom, 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 right? Had to learn that. And one of the first ones that I remember was the Big Red Gum theme.
Okay.
TV commercial theme. Kiss a little longer. Hug a little longer, hold tight a little longer, longer with Big Red, that Big Red freshness.
We're doing right that. Yeah,
that's right. On and on. And I was like, yo.
Do they still run that commercial?
I wish they did.
I haven't heard
that. But like, that song was so good. And I would also write little things. And one of the things my family let me do was sit at the piano and just play whatever, improvise for a long time. And I would just sit and play chords and just not know at all what I was doing technically, but just see how it sounded, and it was really meditative. It still is meditative for me. And I started playing saxophone when I was 8, and the band teacher brought a bunch of instruments down to the cafeteria, and he had them lined all the way up and down the table, and he picked each one and played one. And when he picked up the tenor sax, I thought it was a cool sound, but the thing that really intrigued me about the tenor sax first was how it looked. The saxophone in general is super complex. And also the tenor sax has this curve up the top of the neck, and it was really appealing to me. And I decided to play the saxophone at first based solely on I wanted to get it home and look at it up close and study the really complex workings of it. And I still am impressed with how it is.
I mean, you're absolutely right. The saxophone is quite a complex instrument, mm-hmm. and very useful for creating some complex sounds, complex yes. melody lines. Mm-hmm. Harmonically, it's beautiful at filling in sounds.
Oh, yeah, full overtones.
Yes, absolutely. Mm-hmm. As you've studied, as you developed, can you recall some of the great saxophonists that influenced who mm-hmm. you've become today? Mm-hmm.
For a long time, saxophone was something that I practiced for school and played in the school band, and then for pleasure, I played piano. And I was in way, way into classical music, like I said. There's a famous video by Wynton Marsalis called Blues and Swing, yeah. and he comes to Duke Ellington in 1989 when I was 14, and I'm in that video. And I'm sort of like sitting there like this, because at one point someone asked Wynton, would you like jazz or classical better? And Wynton was like, jazz, no question, mm-hmm, you know? Mm-hmm. And I was just like, what? And so like I was way into classical, but the person who made me decide to become a jazz saxophonist was Coltrane.
Yeah.
I got a tape from one of my friends. On one side was Kind of Blue, and on the other side was Giant Steps. Mm. And another moment that I remember quite vividly was sitting in my living room in Miami, and I put on that tape and just listening to Coltrane play. And you know, a lot of people love Giant Steps and Countdown, and those are really famous, and of course I love those. But what really got to my heart on that record was this tune called Spiral. Mm. And it's one of these tunes that has this long, sort of crying chromatic melody. And I just remember hearing that tone and thinking, okay, this man has 10 fingers and I have 10 fingers, and then he has a saxophone and I have a tenor saxophone, so there might be some chance that I could express myself on this level, wow. and this level of emotional and virtuosic performance level. And I just, you know, he spoke to me so clearly.
How old were you then?
16.
Man. Mm-hmm. I think, like you, when I was in my early teens, I was definitely a classical musician. I had experienced other things, but that's where I was. I'm an opera singer. That's where I was going.
Wonderful.
And I loved it, but I discovered jazz, mm-hmm. you know, and my mother, I don't know, she heard me listening to a Nina Simone album or something. Ooh. And found that I was interested in it and began my education mm-hmm. on jazz mm-hmm. at that point. You certainly went to some great institutions, yeah. got some great background, some great education, and then you meet other musicians. Mm-hmm. I'm sure you've played with a ton, but I'm interested in the two guys you're playing with tonight. Mm-hmm. How long have you all been playing together, and how much music have you made?
Andrew Randazzo and DeVonne Harris, and I think I met DeVonne first back in 2010, and then shortly after I met Andrew in probably 2010 or 2011, we had our first gig together, December in 2011, at this place that used to be, it's a club that's no longer there in Virginia Beach called Havana Nights. Okay. And we played quartet with Steve Kessler, who's another Richmond legend. I remember the first gig I had, though, was with Jason Jenkins and Alan Parker and DeVonne. And we started playing, and I played something, and then he reacted to me, and I kind of looked back, and I'm like, oh, really? and then he played something, and I reacted to him, and he looked at me like, oh, indeed.
Oh.
You know, and so we sort of like, all right, this is great. We love playing each other right off the bat. And then, you know, Andy and DeVonne and I started playing gigs together, my gigs that I, you know, get called for in different places. You know, I'm always out there looking for gigs. And at one point, after we played for a while, Jason Jenkins, the great bass player from Richmond, and Alan Parker started a record label called 32 Bar Records. Mm. And on one of the first releases was the Charles Owens Trio. It was called A Wealth in Common. And it was a really good record, and that began our sort of recording career, but we've been playing together since 2011, and I don't think, I just play great with DeVonne. Like, DeVonne makes me play great, and he and I have great communication.
He really certainly finds interesting pockets to me to add, I don't know, not atypical, but rhythms I'm not expecting to hear, and he finds the perfect pocket, and then the reaction between you and Andrew to his rhythms have been remarkable. Mm-hmm. I'm looking forward to
we
the rest of them.
We both love him so much, and he's a very inspiring guy, and then Andrew, too. It's just an amazing accompanist, mm-hmm. and you know, Andrew will tell you that he thinks of me as a mentor, and I'm very honored for that, and so you can hear my influence on Andrew mm-hmm. and Andrew's music, and I love that.
We've talked on this program a lot about the people who inspire you, the people you're coming up behind, and the education you get. It's so valuable, I think, to the student to recognize that they're learning, but when the teacher realizes that they're teaching when they didn't know it, I think, for me at least, that's an amazing feeling that I always hold. I'm not trying to teach, but sometimes I am.
You never
Once
know
or
what,
twice.
Yeah, you never know who's listening, too, and you never Absolutely. Know what kind of effect you're going to have.
Now, you recently completed a recording project, is that right?
Yeah, in July, we went to Montrose Studios in Richmond, and we did a trio album with Andrew on electric bass and DeVonne on drums, and it's going to, this is the first that I'm saying this, actually.
Oh, wow.
It's going to be released in March on a record label called La Reserve,
All right.
and it's based out of Philadelphia, and we're going to call it 10 Years. Because it's going to be called the Charles Owens Trio 10 Years, because we're celebrating our 10th year anniversary of playing together. And
happy anniversary.
Thank you. It's really rare, you know, when you think of some of the other groups that you love, they didn't stay for 10 years. I mean, the Coltrane Quartet lasted for 4 years, you know, the one that we know about, and then the Beatles lasted for 7, and it's hard to keep a group together.
The Charles Owens Trio's got some legs, I think.
Well, you know, Duke Ellington has a great saying about keeping a band together, because Duke Ellington was born in 1899, and was working with his band by 1920, and he had this band together he died in 72, I think, and when asked, you know, and the band never broke up, and so they asked him, well, what, Duke, what do you do to keep your band together? What's your secret? And he says, you pay them.
Yes, you pay them.
So what that translates to is when we get gigs, I got to make sure that we get enough money so I can get put my best foot forward, and that's Andy and DeVonne.
We appreciate that, we musicians who get the call. My Uncle Norris played with Duke.
Oh, wow.
And had a great
Amazing.
Time with it, yes.
Wow, that's great. What did he play?
He played flute most of the time. Okay. He played saxophone as well.
Mm-hmm. Amazing.
Yeah, yeah.
What a great opportunity.
That's Uncle Norris. Is where he's passed now, but that's his claim to fame. Tell me about the album. I don't want to leave it just yet.
Yeah.
When we get the opportunity to experience it, are we looking at originals or covers?
The first song on the record is an original. It's called Cameron the Wise, and it was a bass. Cameron Ralston is a bass player.
I was about to ask. Is this Cameron?
Yeah, Cameron Ralston is a bass player who I play with often too, not just Andy, but a lot with Cameron, and I love Cameron's playing. And at one point we were playing a gig, and he came up with this amazing bass line. Then he just started playing it, and DeVonne joined in. And then, you know, I walk up on stage, and they stop playing, and I'm like, whoa, you guys just start playing that again, whatever that was. And it was just like an improvised thing. And then it turned into a song that we play, and so we decided to name it after Cameron, because he wrote the bass line to it. So that's called Cameron the Wise. But the rest of the songs are all arrangements of existing songs, but you know, really cool arrangements, stuff that we've been working on, very interesting tunes. We do a Duke Ellington tune called Angelica, and we do Anita Baker, Caught Up in the Rapture.
Okay.
We do a Coltrane tune called Central Park West. Todd Rundgren, I Saw the Light. Mm-hmm. We do Herbie Hancock, Tell Me a Bedtime Story. We even do Kermit the Frog. The Rainbow Connection.
You know, I heard you all sort of picking through that in rehearsal tonight, and I thought, I wonder if they're going to play this Rainbow Connection. I would have wept.
We thought about it. We have so many tunes that we want to try to get to.
If I want to hear Rainbow Connection, I got to pick up this album. That's what that sounds like to me.
It's a good version. I mean, the saxophone, I've never gotten a better recorded saxophone tone than I did on this record. I mean, it's just incredible. And so we're really excited about it. We recorded it directly to 2-inch tape, which means it's an analog recording, and it's really, really fat and live, too. There's no overdubs or punches or anything like that.
Sounds like something to look forward to.
Oh, man. I think everyone's going to really like it. It's my best record, for sure.
March, folks.
March.
You heard it here. March, pick up Charles Owens Trio. What did you call it?
Ten Years.
10 Years, the name of the album.
Mm-hmm.
Pick
On
that up
on La Reserve Records.
Reserve Records.
La Reserve.
La Reserve Records. Mm-hmm. Pick that up. That's going to be a treat. If you're enjoying tonight, you're going to enjoy the second half. Mm-hmm. I've already heard it because I get to sit in the room and listen to rehearsal.
Yeah.
Charles, I think we have talked long enough. I'm ready to hear you play some more.
I'm
ready to hear these other guys beat a drum and, mm-hmm. and pluck a string.
Yeah, yeah.
The next time you come by, I hope I get an opportunity to join you for something.
Oh, please. I would love it. You gotta work that out, man.
Yeah, I mean, I'll be calling ahead of your next gig for sure.
Okay.
Figure out what we can.
Dude,
maybe a little
totally
Rainbow
invited.
Connection.
Yeah, Rainbow Connection.
That might be fun.
Why are there so many
songs about rainbows? Oh, you're gonna get me crying. That's one of my favorites. Who doesn't like
it? It's an emotional song.
Well, Charles, thank you for the chat. Thank you for the music. I'm looking forward to set two. If you're ready, we are ready.
Totally ready. Thank you, Rob. Appreciate
thank
it.
You.
Thank you, Richmond Jazz Society, VMFA, and Rob. Thank you.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm.
right, y'all. We're back for the second set here at VMFA for the Richmond Jazz Society. We thank both of those wonderful organizations for having us. That first song was entitled Love Saves the Day, and that was written by me, Charles Owens. And you can find that on our on this trio's release called A Wealth in Common that we recorded back in 2014. And that is on 32 Bar Records. Shouts to Jason Jenkins and Alan Parker for giving us a shot, our first record together. One of many now. We're going to continue with a song that is, it's called Extra, and it's by a great artist named Lucky Day. And this song was brought to my attention by a great bass player and singer. Her name, and painter, the artist, guitarist, she does it all. She does so much. She's super talented and super deep person, and I'm really glad to know her. So I just wanted to give her a shout out. She's a great musician that you guys will be hearing about. Her name is Elise Underwood, and she's the one who told me about this song. So this is Extra by Lucky Day. Thank you. Yes, sir. Extra by Lucky Day. Thanks, Lucky Day, for that song. Very nicely done, if I do say so. So we're going to do another song by a contemporary artist, or artists, I should say. This one is called The Best Part, or Best Part? It's Best Part. This one's called Best Part by Daniel Caesar, featuring Her, H-E-R. And we all love this song, and we're really happy to play it here at the theater at VMFA for the Richmond Jazz Society. Shouts to BJ and all the great staff over there. Richmond Jazz Society has given me a huge amount of opportunities over the years, and I'll never forget it. So here we go. Best Part. Thank you. Daniel Caesar and Her. Thank you for that song. Best part. If life is a movie, then you're the best part. Great lyrics on that, too.
I think we're going to do one more.
Yeah. Well, it's been a real pleasure to be here this evening here at the theater at VMFA and play this wonderful concert sponsored by them and the wonderful Richmond Jazz Society. On the drums, we have the great and legendary DeVonne Harris, DJ Harrison on drums.
Oh, he's so good, don't you agree?
He's so good, don't you agree? On the hybrid guitar tonight, we have the great Andrew Randazzo on the hybrid guitar. Once again, this is the Charles Owens Trio. Thank you, VMFA. Thank you, Richmond Jazz Society. We are now going to play a blues written by Andrew. And we like to play this in all kinds of different keys, and we're going to decide right now what key we're going to play it in. You can let Robert pick. Robert, you want to have a little interaction? G. Thank you, Robert. We're going to play this blues in G.
All right.
Actually, he did tell us. Thank you.
That's Charles, Owens Trio.
Yes, sir.
Thank you, gentlemen, for tonight. You know, I think tonight I felt a mixture of tucked away beneath a sturdy roof in the cold of winter and cruising on a hot summer night. A little bit of both. I hope you take that with you tonight, tomorrow, through the summer. And these guys will be back on this stage sometime to jam out again with us soon.
For sure.
Thank you, Charles Owens Trio. Thank you, Richmond Jazz Society. Thank you, Dominion Energy. Thank you, Remembered Tommy Productions. And thank you at all of you at home, for loving with us. Thank you for listening to us, and thank you for learning from us. As always, from the Leslie Cheek Theater at the Virginia Museum of Fine Arts in Richmond, Virginia, this has been our virtual Dominion Energy Jazz Cafe. I, of course, am Robert Fennard. Good night.